Hello friends, welcome to the English Hater. I am Dr. Amit Ranjan. In this video, I will be discussing the sentence structures in the past indefinite tense. That is, I will be discussing the structures of the affirmative statements, the negative statements, the yes or no type questions, the WH word type questions, as well as the negative interrogative sentences, etc., etc. in this tense. So watch this video till the end. You are going to learn a lot today. Now, those of you who are still new to my channel, please subscribe to it and press the bell icon so that you keep getting my latest updates in English language and literature. So let us start the sentence structures in the past indefinite tense. I'll first give you the formula for the affirmative statements in this tense. That is, you take a subject first and with it you use the V2 form of a verb. Now, to those of you who are still not familiar with the term V2, I recommend that you watch my that video in which I have discussed in detail all the 5 forms of verbs which are used to form different kinds of tenses. I have provided the link of that video in the description box below. So here is the basic formula for the affirmative statements in the past indefinite tense. That is, subject plus V2, and this is applicable to all the subjects, whether singular or plural. Additionally, you can use other words if required. Now let us see some of the examples. Here are these: I ate pizza today. We learned verb forms that day. You slept for an hour last night. He came home yesterday. She fell ill last Monday. It hurt me a lot. They played very well. Now let us see how to make the negative statements in this tense. That is, you take the subject first and then you use the auxiliary verb did plus not plus V1 here. Additionally, you can use other words if required, and this formula is also applicable to all the subjects, whether singular or plural. So let us see some of the examples. Here are these: I did not eat pizza today. We didn't want any help. You didn't sleep last night. He didn't meet me yesterday. She didn't prepare breakfast this morning. It didn't hurt me much. They didn't play very well. Now, having said that, you should not make such statements as "we did not knew." Why? Because once you have used did, which itself is the V2 form of the auxiliary verb to do, you should not use the V2 form of the main verb. Okay, so such sentences are wrong. You should use the V1 form instead, as suggested in the formula which I have just told you. However, you might come across such sentences as "we knew not," but such sentences are only possible in poetry, and you should not use such sentences in your formal speech or writing. Okay, now let us see how to make the yes or no type questions in this tense. You used auxiliary verb did before the subject, and then you used the V1 form of the main verb plus additionally other words if required, and don't forget to put the question mark because you are asking a question here. Again, this formula is also valid with all the subjects, whether singular or plural. Now let us see some of the examples. Here are these: did I teach you well today? Did we not learn verb forms that day? Didn't you sleep last night? Did he go to school regularly? Didn't she write you a letter yesterday? Did it not rain for long there? Didn't they shout in the class? Now you might notice that I have taken the examples of the positive as well as the negative questions together with the contractions. Now let us see how to make the WH word type questions. As I have discussed with the present indefinite tense, such WH word questions follow 2 patterns. I have provided the link of that video in the description box below. You can watch that video. That will help you a lot in understanding this section. Okay, so there are 2 patterns with the WH word type questions. In pattern 1, we have the subject available with us, and this is the formula for such questions. You take the WH word first plus did plus subject plus V1 plus additional words if required plus a question mark. In the pattern 2 where we don't have the subject available with us or it is attached with the WH word itself, then this is the formula we use. We use the WH word first, which itself acts as a subject, and we take the V2 form of the main verb plus additional words if required plus a question mark. However, we must use did plus not plus V1 if we want to make the negative questions. Here are the examples. What did I teach today? Who did we not like? Or whom did we not like? What did he want? Which pen did you use? What didn't John do? When did you study? Why did they shout? How did it fall down? Why didn't she come? Where did John live? Etc. etc. Now with the pattern 2. What brought you here? Who didn't attend my class? Which pen wrote well? Whose dogs did not bark here? Etc. etc. Now let us see how to express the state of being in the past. Here is the formula. You take either was or were depending upon the number and the person of the subject together with a complement. Was is used with singular subjects except you, and were is used with you and plural subjects. Here are some of the examples. I was ill yesterday. We were not here that day. Why weren't you present today? Who was he? Whose was that dog? Which pen was yours? How weren't they bullies, etc., etc. Now let us see how to make sentences showing possession or ownership in the past. That is the use of the verb to have in the past indefinite tense. Here are two alternative patterns. We either take the help of the V2 form of the verb to have, that is had, or alternatively we use the V2 form of the auxiliary verb to do, and then in that case we use the V1 form of the main verb to have, and they are applicable to all the subjects whether singular or plural. Here are some of the examples. I had a car. You had not enough courage. Had he money? Didn't she have beauty? Who hadn't intelligence? When had they fever? Which books did we not have? Etc. etc. Now this is all from my side for today. In the next video I will take up this topic, that is the uses of the past indefinite tense. So if you have enjoyed this video, then press the like button and share it to as many people as possible. Bye for now. Keep watching my videos. Enjoy learning.